Everyone, Ms. Jones here. This week for math, we are talking about the standard of graphing and using data and interpreting that data. Okay, so we've talked about this year, but not really diving deep into it. So this week, we are going to dive deep into different types of graphing and graphs, and then looking at data, recording data, and figuring out how to use that information. So before we get started, we're just going to go over some of our new vocabulary. So our new vocab for this unit, okay, the word data, or some of you say data, you can say it either way. I just say data. So data is items of information. It may include facts, numbers, or measurements. So on here, I'm going to zoom it. It says a group of 21 students were asked what their favorite fruit was. 7 students said apples, 4 said bananas, and 10 said oranges. And that was their favorite. So then they used that data, okay? They have it bolded at 21 students because that was the total number. That was the sum. That was everyone in that survey. And a survey is just like a questionnaire. A survey is when you ask questions and you try to get information. So this survey was all about favorite fruits. There was 21 students. And then through this data, okay, they did use a graph, and we'll talk about that in a second. They showed how many students liked which one. So there were the apples, there was the bananas, and there was the oranges. And you can use this data and you can ask questions. So what was the most? Who liked the most? What fruit was the most? What was the least? Okay. What was anything equal? I would use those fewer, most. Those are some words that you're going to be hearing. Okay, next, we have a table or a chart. So the first thing that we're going to be learning this week is about tally charts. And this is a table. It says a collection of data that has been organized into columns and rows. And we said that columns go up and down and rows go horizontal, okay, across. So these are your columns. These are your rows. Awesome. So it says there's usually headings or a title. Okay, they tell you what's in each row. Usually it's bolded. Okay, we always start with that data. So this looks like birds of prey. And this table is all about different types of prey. There's a raven, a hawk, and a kestrel. Different types of birds of prey. All right, then we're going to get into bar graphs. Bar graph is another type of graph, okay? Different graphs just show the same data just differently. So this bar graph shows it in bars, okay? So we have favorite after school wheels. Some students like skateboards, some like inline skates, and some like their bicycle. So these are kind of like rollerblades. And then it usually has the numbers going across to tell you how many students liked each thing. So it says number of students. So let's see, how many students liked skateboards? Remember, read across, always starting at 0, where those lines meet, those axes, okay? And then you go up, and you try to find how many people like skateboards. Boop, skateboards is 8. All right, how many people like rollerblades? Same thing, look at your eyes, and go down to the number, boop. Yeah, 6. And how many liked bikes? Remember, follow the bar, look down, where does it go to? 9, awesome. So that is our bar graph. A picture graph, guess what's on a picture graph? Pictures. So instead of showing a bar like this, okay, they're actually showing pictures as the amount. So this one says students who wore tie shoes, and then number of students. Okay, so this is from room 7, room 8, and room 9. So it looks like room 9 had the most students that wore tied shoes. Okay, so picture graphs, depending on the graph, most of them are just telling data, okay? They're explaining the survey, the information, and showing it to you in different ways. Okay, so you can look at some of our Brain Pop assignments this week. That will help a lot by watching those videos and kind of explaining different graphs to you. There's some practice on IXL we're going to be doing this week that go right along with our data and interpreting graphs. So really look at that letter and numbers that I'm assigning to you. Remember, if you go on IXL, there's a little star in the corner once you log in, and that will tell you what you're specifically doing on IXL for that day. Awesome. All right, my friends. And the last thing I wanted to go over was just our tally marks. And we've done this all year, but I just want to make sure, because if you see tally marks on a graph, I want to make sure you can read it the right way using those tally marks. So if I have a tally mark, just like that line, what does that represent? How much is that? What is the value of this little tally mark? Yeah, one. So one line equals one. But now, let's look, let's count at these. How many do I have here? Four. What is our rule when we have five? What do I need to do? Because remember, our brains, we always use tally marks to help our brains count quicker and faster. So yeah, if I want to make five, I'm going to cross it, okay? Just like that. So then that looks like one group and I can just count it quick, five. I don't have to go one, two, three, four, five. So when I have tens, I made another group. Now I can count quicker by fives, five, 10. And what I love to do is I love to, what do I like to do? I like to circle it because that helps my brain know even quicker, boom, that's 10. And now I can count by tens. So tallies really help us count quicker, counting by fives, tens, okay? So if I have another group of 10, then that means we're counting by tens. And let me circle it. So now I can go, instead of going 5, 10, 15, 20, or going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way up to 20, that would take forever. I'm just going to be going 10, 20. And you can do that on your tally graphs as well, in your tally charts. All right, my friends. Good luck. If you have any questions, please reach out to me. Please follow the slides for this week. Monday through Thursday, I have new slides. On Fridays, it's more of an enrichment review day, so I will not be having slides on Fridays anymore. However, I will be having slides for language arts and math Monday through Thursday. Unless that we're off for Memorial Day, you won't have any work that day, of course. All right, my friends, have a great week this week learning about graphs and interpreting data.